Fashion has always been changing throughout the years in terms of evolving new designs, styles, and patterns, but so has being inspired by many cultures and religions to create fashion. Many people criticize that high or luxurious fashion houses are notorious for culturally appropriating in order to gain profits and recognition for their clothing lines as if it was their own. Gucci, Chanel, among many others, have gotten away with cultural appropriating. Back then, people found it unique or exotic instead of understanding or learning that some of the designs had an actual meaning behind it. The Islamic culture is one of the common cultures in fashion that luxury brands have based their concepts on. The hijab specifically is being used as an accessory in catalog shoots or on the runway. Muslims have long been neglected in the fashion world, but suddenly, when designers start to use a hijab or modest clothing, they aren't even represented well. Dolce & Gabbana and Versace, to name a few, have created headscarves specifically for Muslim women, but advertised with unmodest clothing and non-Muslim models, though not fulfilling the actual need for Muslim women wanting to wear luxury brands that are also modest enough to wear. It also takes away the opportunity for Muslim designers such as Ibtihaj Mohammed for Luella or Azrina Tahar for Sophia. Catherine Bullock, in her journal piece titled Pious Fashion, How Muslim Women Dress, talks about Elizabeth Bhaskar speaking on hijabs being a normal piece of clothing rather than something that should be identified as indifferent to others because it is just that, a normal article of clothing. Bullock says she normalizes hijab so that it can be studied, not as some kind of weird, exotic, oppressive, sui generis piece of cloth, but like any other piece of woman's clothing, like miniskirts, jeans, high heels, or the bra. While modest clothing can indeed be used as a form of social control or as a display of religious orthodoxy, in practice it is both much less and much more. Kanza Chaudhary, a young Muslim woman living here in NYC, defines a hijab as a covering not only for your head, but for your behavior, gaze, body, and mind, explaining that you should not let bad intent take control over you in situations and be the best version of yourself as possible.
People don't know who you are, but they know you're a Muslim woman, so you're representing Islam to people. So you want to give the best representation possible because people aren't going to pick up a Quran and they're not going to read it. They're going to read you.
The Islamic culture and fashion also brings attention to social and political issues as well. It creates a double standardization in society to see that Islamic fashion is banned in 15 countries, but yet many of the designers who are based within these countries still use it as inspiration. It also brings a social issue to see how celebrities like Cardi B can wear a full-on hijab with a dress that also covers her entire body in a modest way. Like the Tom Brown gown she wore at the 2019 Met Gala, or even the niqab-inspired look she wore in Paris for Paris Fashion Week made by Richard Quinn. But still, she gets praised for it instead of being oppressed like how Muslim women usually face.
Do you feel like a lot of the fashion houses are like using hijab as an accessory to profit off of that or like to gain? Like you saw the Cardi B thing, right?
Yeah.
With the whole niqab and the burqa.
Yes,
thing.
That was, I felt offended because if I were to wear a niqab, a full abaya, a full burqa in France, I would get arrested, I would get a fine. But someone that's an influencer, that's not necessarily, like, that's not even a Muslim woman, was able to cover entirely every, like, part of her body, every skin, no hair was showing, none of her face, not even her eyes were showing, and she got away with it because it was fashion.
Mm-hmm.
But when people do it out of the sake for their religion, for sake of their religion and for their identity, we get like, you know, we're told not to do it because it's not right. But that's who are they to tell me what's wrong and what's not, you know, what's right. For me, like, it's part of my religion, it's part of who I am. And I think covering isn't a bad thing. If girls are allowed to uncover themselves, girls should be able to cover themselves too.
There are many Muslim models who are thriving in the fashion world and are well known, such as model Halima Adeen, who loves her hijab and isn't afraid to express her identity as a Muslim woman in the fashion industry. We can only hope that there will be more opportunities for more Muslim designers and models to show their talents in this fashion industry.